This tutorial is about setting custom resolutions in Linux VirtualBox VMs. I will be demonstrating on both CentOS 7 and Mint 17.1, but these techniques should apply to any distro running X11, including Ubuntu. This method will allow you to change to any specific resolution that your hardware will support. However, the focus here will be on 16:9. I will also show you how to make your new resolution stick across reboots. I'm starting with two VMs that have just booted for the first time. That's CentOS on the left and Mint on the right. If I try to change the resolution in CentOS, you can see that I have only two choices and both are 4:3. Over in Mint, I have a few more options, but still no 16:9 choices. However, in Mint, if I hit the full screen button, the resolution will be dynamically set for me. You can see now that the resolution inside Mint has become 2560 by 1296. This is because Mint comes pre-packaged with VirtualBox Guest Editions, which is software installed on your guest OS, in this case Linux Mint, that allows two-way communication between VirtualBox and the guest OS. So VirtualBox is able to tell my VM what resolution it wants it to be, and the VM complies automatically. I can also click and drag to resize the window, with the VM changing its resolution as necessary. In CentOS, if I try the same thing, my window will change, but my VM remains the same. This is because CentOS does not ship with guest editions pre-installed. So let's install that now. All you need to do is make sure your VM window is active and click Devices, Insert Guest Editions CD Image. This will auto-run the installation script and you just click Run. Once the installation is completed and after a reboot, you'll note that we can drag to resize or click full screen just like in Mint. But also just like Mint, we still don't have any 16:9 choices. Our next step is going to be to use two command line programs in conjunction with each other to set our desired resolution. The first is xrandr, or X11 Resize and Rotate. This program sends configuration parameters to X11, and we're going to use it to tell X11 what resolution we want. However, xrandr requires some very granular technical details, so before we can use it, we're going to use another program to calculate those details for us. CVT, or Calculate VESA CVT Mode Lines, is used in conjunction with xrandr to calculate arguments for it. The format we'll use is CVT X Y Refresh Rate. You can choose whatever resolution and refresh rate you prefer, but I'm going to use 1920 by 1080 at 60 Hz. So I just type CVT 1920 1080 60. CVT spits out a lot of numbers, but they are helpfully formatted for the xrandr command. The part we'll need to use is everything after the word mode line. Now we're ready to use xrandr to change the resolution. To do that, we'll issue three commands. First, we'll define a mode, then we'll add that mode to xrandr's repertoire, and then we'll activate that mode. So for the first command, I'll type xrandr dash dash new mode, and then copy and paste the entire string that CVT gave me. CVT has helpfully given us a name here in quotes, followed by all the parameters we need. Next, we'll need to add this new mode to xrandr's repertoire. We do that with xrandr dash dash add mode, and now I need two arguments, the name of the display and the name of the mode that I just defined. If I run xrandr in another window with no arguments, it tells me the name of the active display. So now I can type VGA dash 0 and the name of the mode that I just created, 1920 by 1080 _60.00. The last thing to do is activate this mode. I do that by typing xrandr dash dash output VGA dash 0 dash dash mode 1920 by 1080 _60.00. And there it is. I now have a glorious 16:9 window at the exact resolution I want. Moving back to Mint, it is, ironically, more difficult to achieve our desired result because they have so helpfully installed guest editions for us. If I try the same series of commands on Mint, you can see that it fails. And if you check the official VirtualBox documentation, the recommendation is to remove pre-packaged versions of guest editions and reinstall from scratch. Thankfully, this is easy to do. I just run sudo apt-get purge VirtualBox star, and that will remove the guest editions for me. Then I can proceed as before, going to Devices, Insert Guest Edition CD Image, and allowing the installation to complete. After a restart, I just enter the CVT and xrandr commands in the same manner as before. This is all well and good in theory, But in practice, you probably don't want to go through all this applesauce every time you log in. To automate the process, first create a script that contains the three xrandr commands and make it executable. If you only want to resize the window sometimes but not all the times when you log in, just create a link to your script on the desktop. Now you can simply double-click to resize the window. If, however, you want the window to resize automatically every time you log in, simply add the script to your startup applications. First, click Menu, Preferences, Startup Applications. Click the button to add a new application. Give it a title, and in the command line, type the command to execute your script. Make sure you use the absolute path to your script here. Using a tilde to represent your home directory will not work. Save the entry, and you're done. The script will now execute every time you log into your graphical environment. If you have any questions, please ask below and I'll do my best to answer. Also, if you have any Linux tutorial video requests, just leave them in the comments. And please click like and hit subscribe just because I need the validation. Thanks for watching.